Welcome to EWN On The Couch, where we catch up with your favorites both on and off the field. And now, no doubt, mountain biking is the next big thing in South Africa. It's taken us all by storm, and it's so cool to see the youngsters coming through. I've got one here from Namibia, but he's in South Africa at the moment, Tristan de Lange. Thanks for joining us on the couch.
Thank you very much for having me.
Two-time gold medalist, or at the moment, two gold medals at the African Games, most recent African Games. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You happy with that?
I'm very happy with that. Yeah, they mean a lot to me. It was a very good experience.
So the lead up to that, I heard you had an operation?
Yes. My year started off very well, but then I had a bit of a hiccup with heart. I had a tachycardia, which needed to be sorted out. That took me out of Epic as well, which was a big blow. Mm. And that took me 3-4 weeks to come to be able to start training again properly. Yeah, and then the months leading up to that, my performance bettered and bettered and was a perfect peak to the African Games.
Absolutely fantastic. So what does this mean, doing well at the African Games? Because I know Tokyo 2020 is looming. So yeah. How important is it to place well at something like this?
The African Games means a lot for not only the host nations, but also for the Olympic committees themselves, because as it being a pre-Olympic year, obviously every athlete that has the potential to be at the 2020 Olympics is in the eyes of their federation, the Olympic Committee. So if you perform well there, you've got a very good chance, or your chance is better. There's still, obviously, the competition doesn't stop until things are actually over.
So you studying in South Africa, but your host nation, your nation, he just said he's in the Rugby World Cup, it's Namibia all the way. In Namibia, what's the process now getting to Tokyo 2020, and how big of a team is the federation going to send? Do you know?
Well, at this point, we can't send a large team, as because it comes down to the country and it's qualifying spots. So we've got one for the mountain bike men's, one for the road men's, and we're hoping to still get the spot for the ladies road and the ladies road as well as the, and we've also got the ladies mountain bike. So we've got full out. One in each category. Yep. Unfortunately, because we're such a small nation, we don't have enough points for the country to qualify for more spots. Because the closer you are to the first position in the world, the more spots you get.
So where's Namibia at the moment?
I can't tell you. I think we rank between 40th and 50th.
Okay.
Because there's only a few of us collecting the points compared to a country like Switzerland, where you've got 50 people or 100 people competing for points for the country.
And then being in South Africa, studying at Stellenbosch University, how have Stellenbosch helped getting your career, you know, keeping it going, and then Namibia as well? I mean, you're basically an international student, Namibia's native.
Yeah. And I have to admit, Stellenbosch University has been extremely helpful. They've always supported me into where I'm going and helped me that I can still complete my studies with the necessary time. The lecturers have made themselves available. Mm. And they've always been very lenient with me, and they've been helpful.
They've been very helpful.
Very helpful.
And then what are you studying at Monty's at the moment?
I'm studying financial accounting at the moment.
Gee.
I've completed my 50th year of studies now. It's only a 3-year course, but I've decided to plan things to give myself the time to be able to train and do the things that I can at this age.
Because that's the thing, is we've had a few student athletes on this couch, and it's every time it's like you just realize how tough it is to get a full-on degree and start a professional sporting career.
Yeah, it takes a lot, because when you're on tour, you take your things with you. For me, I've loaded everything onto a laptop so that I don't have to carry all the books. Mm-hmm. But yeah, when you're on the flights, it's studying. When you're resting with the legs up pre-race, it's studying. You know, you do what you have to.
How did you fall in love with mountain biking?
My father...
Oh, I love it when it starts like that, because then there's a story. Okay, yeah?
My father actually started with the mountain biking. And it was tradition for the family. Myself, my sisters, my mother and my father, we all did the Cycle Classic, which was once a year. It's like the Namibian August, call it that.
Okay.
And it was compulsory for us kids to do the 30 kilometer with our mother. And it was every year the same thing. And my father actually did 5 Cape Epics at that stage.
Wow.
And then whenever he'd finish his training, he'd take me out afterwards. And from there on, yeah, it was doing the local cross countries for the fun, then getting into it with friends, and then things just took off from there.
So is your dad your professional coach? Your
No, I moved on at about age 17.
And he's okay with that?
Yeah.
He's okay, all right.
Yeah, it was actually his recommendation.
There we go.
So things were like.
So when you are touring all across the country or all across the globe, does the family come join you sometimes or do they watch from afar?
Sometimes my folks come with me. If it's local races, sometimes I hope more in the future as well. But now and then my sisters do come along as well. But they've obviously also got their work to deal with. My mother comes with overseas now and then as well, but mostly it's my father that travels with me because he knows how I operate, he knows what's required, he knows how to feed me during the races, and he can read me as well, so it makes things easier for myself.
So as a young cyclist, how do you go about getting the funds to be able to appoint a mechanic or a manager or whatever?
Yeah, things are very difficult that stage, especially with the state of the economy as it is at the moment. Most of the time you take what you can get, you dig for scraps, but for me, I'm very fortunate to have the support and sponsors that I do. That helped me a lot in my junior years. I had very good results and they helped me gain the platform I needed to have the support that I have now through under 23 and going into elite now. And yeah, so on the financial side, I'm very lucky considering. And yeah, you obviously still manage with a budget and things are still limited to a degree, but you do what you can with what you have.
All right, but before you go, we play a little game called Just Be Honest. Only allowed yes or no answers. Okay. So no lying. Namibia's on the line here. Yeah. Oh, now you're nervous. Okay. Is it true you were a rock star in your previous life?
Yes.
Is it true you are only a true mountain biker when you've crashed?
Yes.
Knew it. Do Namibians exclusively drink beer for breakfast?
No.
Damn it. Damn it, Namibia. Have you ever missed a test because you mistimed a cycle?
No.
He says looking down, I wonder.
I had to think again, but I didn't. I haven't.
Okay, well, do you name your bikes?
Yes, I do.
Okay, what's your current bike's name?
Lucy.
Yeah. Well, Lucy and Tristan, good luck. Good luck with the Olympic testing.
Thank you very much.
So exciting, and we look forward to seeing you at the Olympic Games in 2020.
Thank you very much for having me. It's been great.
Hey, good luck with the tests. These guys are busy with tests. Student athletes.
It's another test tomorrow, but a different test event.
Tristan, thank you so much for joining us and good luck. All right.
Thank you very much.
There we go. Follow Tristan DeLange's journey on Instagram. We'll tag him. Enum Sport will be following him. And who knows, we might see him at Tokyo 2020. Thanks for joining us on EWN On The Couch.